Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. If you are new to using DaVinci Resolve or Fusion, I have a little text tutorial for you. And in this tutorial, I'll show you how you can do this wiggle text like you see right here. And again, it's not too complicated to do inside of Fusion, so that is what we're going to do in this video. If you do like this kind of content, please do consider to subscribe, like, and share with your friends. And if you really like the tip I'm giving you today, please consider to donate me a cup of coffee, because I do love my coffee. And of course, you can do that by clicking the thanks icon down below this video. Well, with that out of the way, let's get right into this tutorial. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's get started by doing a wiggle effect. First thing we need to do is to go up to the effects, take a Fusion composition and add that down to our timeline. I already did that, so with that selected, let's jump into Fusion. What we have here in Fusion is a background node connected to the media out. And in between that, we have a merge and a text node. With the text node selected, we're going to go up here and I'm going to right click. And I'm going down to choose follower. And then I'll just go into the shading tab. And in the shading tab, we are going to work with the position and the rotation. So the basic idea here is to move stuff around. So first off, I'll be at the beginning of my timeline. I'm going to go into the offset here and I'm going to put in a keyframe. Then I'll just randomly go a little forward and I'll move it up just a little bit. I'll go a little forward and I'll move it back again like that. Go a little forward, adding in a new keyframe and a new position. And I'm going to do this super random, because there shouldn't be like a system in this. The only thing that's important is it going up and down. Okay, for the next one, I'll be like that. Okay, that's enough randomness for this. Let's go to the beginning of the timeline again. And this time I'll go into the rotation, put in a keyframe at the Z, and I'm going to do the exact same thing. Again, totally random, going from the one side to the other side. Again, doesn't have to be any system or anything like that. It can be super random. And it is super random. Something like that. Great. So now we have this little effect here. Seeking and sagging, something like that. Totally random. So let's make this a little bit better by going up to the spline. And I'm going to select the text here. So everything is selected. I'll just make this a little bit smaller so I can highlight everything. And if I just push this icon down here, I'm going to set up a loop. And what that is going to do is just going to repeat my movement, like you see here, for the rest of this composition. It'll just continue, continue, continue. Super. Again, going to highlight everything. And then I'm just going to push F for flatten. So it's going to be a little more smooth when we're doing the effect. So here we have that. Cool. One thing to add in here would be to go into the modifiers, going into the follower one, and going into this timing here. And what I want to do here is the order of things. I want to change that to be completely random. And again, how fast it's going to be random, we're going to do that in the delay. And again, delay is the amount of frames it's going to be moving according to the last movement. So let's say we're going to do like, let's see, 4 frames maybe. Let's try that out at least. So here we have this wiggle effect with text wiggling continuously forever, because we set the effect up like this. Last thing to add in would be to go into the merge and go into settings and add in some motion blur. And then we have this little wiggle effect here with motion blur and everything. Crazy, crazy fun. And again, if you want to have a different background or something like that, you would just have to go into the background, go into the alpha and move that all the way down so you can put whatever in your background, or you could of course also just change the background color if you don't want to have a black background. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.